Hello friends, welcome to my channel Animated Study.
Today we will see insertion in doubly linked list at the head and tail side. So here we have a list with first node that is pointed by the head. Now if you want to insert the node from the front, you are taking one empty node and then you are setting the left pointer null because it is the first node. Then you are setting the data part, that is 5 here, and the new node right pointer is indicating the head node, while the head node left pointer indicating the new node. And don't forget to drag the head pointer to the first node. Now suppose if you want to insert the node at the end of the list, then you are taking the new node. You are always looking for the right as a null pointer. So here you can see first node right pointer is not null. So you are moving ahead. You are checking the null pointer for the second node. Here for the second node right pointer is not null. You are moving ahead to the third node and you can see third node right pointer is null. So it is the last node. After this node you want to insert the new node. So you are taking the node, adding the data part, that is 75 here, then taking right pointer null because it is the last node. Then you are taking the right pointer of earlier tail node to the new node and new node left pointer to the earlier last node. And this is the insertions at the end side. Now we will see basic structure of node in doubly linked list. So here you see structure node having one pointer, that is left, that is pointing to the previous node or left node. Then you have a data part here and right pointers, that is pointing to the next node, and you are taking the head node as a global variable and initially it is null here. Now you are calling insert start functions to add the node from the front side or head side. Then you are taking any data, say here 10, and you are executing the next instructions in which you are creating the new node with the malloc function. So here you can see one new node is created with a pointer new node with address 100. Then you set the new node left is equal to null because we are inserting the node at the front. So left pointer is always null here. Then you set the data part, that is 10 here. So you set the 10. Then you check the condition. If head is equal to null, here you can see head pointer is pointing to the null. So you go inside the if condition and set new node right pointer also null here. So here you can see your new node with both pointer left and right are null here. Then you take head is equal to new node. So we are dragging the head pointer to the new node. So your list is ready with the one node. Now if you want to insert the new node again, then you are taking one data, that is 5 here. Then again you are allocating the memory and creating the new node, that is on address 300. And then you set the left pointer null here. Then you set the data part, that is 5 here. Then you check the condition. If head is equal to null, here you can see head is not equal to null because it is on 100 address. So you go to the else part. In that first instructions is new node right is equal to head. So you set the right pointer of new node to the head node. So it is 100 here and head left is equal to new node. So head left is right now null, that is modified to the address of new node here. So you can see 300 in the left pointer of the head. And now you drag your head pointers to the new node. So head is pointing now the first node of the linked list. Now suppose if you want to insert the node at the end, and in which we are taking any data like 20 here. So again you are allocating the memory to the new node with the malloc function, and then you are taking new node data part is equal to 20 here. So here you can see 20 is the data part of the new node, and since it is the last node, its new node right pointer is always null. So we are setting null here. Then again we are checking the conditions. If head is equal to null, that means suppose if your entire list is empty, you are taking new node left is also null, and you are calling head is equal to new node, but it is not the case here. So we are going to the else part, in which we are taking one temporary pointer. So here you can see one temporary pointer. Now we will call temp is equal to head. So our temp is now pointing to the head node. Its address is 300 here. Now you are checking while conditions, that is temp write not equal to null. So here you can see temp write is 100. It is not equal to null. So condition true. You are going inside the while loop in which you have a temp is equal to temp write. So temp write is 100. So you are shifting the pointer to the next node having address 100. Then again you are checking the while conditions, that is temp write not equal to null, but here you can see temp write is null here. So condition false. So you are going to the next instructions in which temp write is equal to new node. So temp write is right now null. Now you are pointing to the new node, that's address is 150. So instead of null, we are setting here 150. And new node left is equal to temp here. So new node left pointer is right now empty. So you're setting to the left having address 100. And this is all about the insertion in doubly linked list. So if you like this video, subscribe the channel and share the video. And don't forget to press the bell icon for my new video notifications. Thanks for watching.